Yeah. I request the first slide, the presentation to be put on. And at the outset, I'm extremely grateful to BIPA for inviting me. John, Peter, Raj Agarwal, and all were in touch with me, and they brought me here. I'm grateful to you. And microbials means parasitoids and predators. And I'm not very comfortable speaking this to an audience who have put the commercial bioindustry of our country on the international map, simply because we do not have any parasitoids or predators in a commercial sense. And therefore, my talk would probably, I'm not sure, would stimulate some commercialization in this area. Now, if you look at this, sir, can I?
Hello, hello. Yeah. Now, if I would say, since the major success we had with DDT, the limitations that was brought out by Rachel Carson's Silent Spring put brakes on the chemical industry. And then we had in the 70s a concept called the integrated pest management. And integrated pest management slowly clawed its way with the use of insecticides that got integrated. And as a result, 99% of IPM was nothing but insecticides only. And for namesake, we have this term IPM, and it has almost become a cliche today. Now, if you look carefully at the slide which I am presenting, you see that biocontrol using parasitoids or predators have been successful only if there is no insecticide use or low insecticide use. I'm just giving two examples, the sugarcane woolly aphid and the papaya mealybug. In both these cases, insecticides, you know, sugarcane insecticidal spray after a stage is impossible. In papaya, it is absolutely not needed. It's only people have some panic spray of imidacloprid for controlling ring spot virus, which is also not essential. Now, so these two crops have no insecticides, and therefore, biocontrol with a single release, not even indentative or inoculative release, has worked. Now, if you see this tomato, Tuta absoluta, which came in 2014, we all worked at the NBAR, and we had a host of parasitoids discovered, and we published it in Current Science also. And but what happened? When the pinhole borer, which attacks the tomato, a single spray of flubendamide, that's all, the entire lot of parasitoids disappeared. So today also, Tuta absoluta, you know, you can control only with, say, azadirachtin and pheromones. And parasitoids are only there on paper because we cannot avoid insecticides. Now, how exactly to actuate these microbials? One excellent model is the rice ecosystem in Thrissur, Manuti, Kerala. You know what? The state government has given all the infrastructure in terms of breeding for parasitoids. So they have given almost 30 to 40% support. And now the farmers have been told not to spray insecticides, and many of them don't spray insecticides. They believe in organic. So almost 13 hectares of rice in Manuti are without insecticides, and Trichogramma is sold there. And Trichogramma, then Trichoderma, and then you have Pseudomonas also. All these things are brought, and the lab in Manuti, Thrissur, is run on a profitable basis, and it is commercial. But there is a state support, which I want to emphasize. And this can be done again in sugarcane, maize, coconuts. Now, for the private industry,
You know, this should be the approach. Now, if the state is not supporting, you all cannot have parasitoids or predators. So, State Agriculture University, ICAR, KVKs should offer space or you know, temporary structures in the field during the season, and see, and they should give other know-hows. Now, suppose you have to establish the whole thing, it will be very costly. To rear parasitoids, you have to rear a host insect called Coursera. Now, Coursera rearing is very costly. And if the state government can give, the state universities can give that, then these parasitoids and predators can be reared. One example is the horticulture, YSR Horticulture University, which is in Venkatramanagudam. Now, there, they are supplying the Coursera eggs. And the commercial people are multiplying a predator. What happens? It is semi-viable. Otherwise, it's certainly not viable. Now, if you look at the predators, predators are more viable for commercial production. There was a time when I used to recommend Cryptolemus montrosirae for the grape mealybug control in PCI. But they found it difficult to rear the way we have on pumpkins and the supply and cannibalism of the grubs. So they wound it up. And I know Dr. Uday is sitting here. They are ready to release Cryptolemus and give it to the grape growers. And grape growers in Maharashtra, they can afford it. But, you know, they have many legalistic and administrative issues, and they are not able to do it. They have also stopped. Now, what I found in South Africa, in Stellenbosch, you know, you have a rearing houses in the vineyard, you know, staked, you know, you have these pumpkins hanging from 8 feet above, and big houses in the grape field, run by private people and the grape growers. They just walk in, take the predatory grubs, release in the field. So that kind of an approach, if can be made commercially viable, only then it will be possible. Now, predatory mites. Now, predatory mites, we are rearing in bread boxes, and we have published in Current Science. Good, academically. That is mass rearing. Mass rearing is not commercial rearing. Commercial rearing needs a different kind of research. So I told in the last All India Coordinated Biocontrol, our now focus should be on research on upscaling commercial rearing. Only then the commercial people can take up. That means we should have big greenhouses, glass houses, walk-in houses where predators can be reared, and that can be harvested and released. Otherwise, in boxes, bread boxes, no, it is not possible at all, and no commercial people would come forward to do that. And that's why we don't have them here. The biocontrol research in India, which is almost 100 years old, have been having its great glory. But interventional biocontrol, that means farmer buying, using, needs a million-fold scaling up. Otherwise, it is not possible. We have international biocontrol suppliers, which, you know, we need to take a cue from them. And we have people like Uday, who know it all, you know, and who can probably help, you know. That bell says how many minutes more? 2 more minutes, okay. So we need to do this scaling up. And I'm happy that many commercial organizations, many of you here, are using BRAC programs. Now, BRAC is an excellent program. And for parasitoids, predators, the microbials, you know, microbes are good. I'm for it. But microbials also, BRAC program for research on upscaling is needed. So that is what is needed. And for pollinators, there are many wild pollinators, but we can't catch them and sell them. But pollinators, we can hire, and there are only 2 species. One is this Apis species, the domestic bee. And another one is the stingless bee, Trigonella. Now, NBAIR in Bangalore has scaled up, and they have shown how it can be mass multiplied. And for greenhouses and polyhouses, Trigonella is one of the best pollinators, not the Apis. So this is something which you can do, and they don't swarm like the other bee. Now, and moreover, honeybee, you have several products. Korea is the example. Several products, including cosmetic creams, you know. So way forward, way onward is scaling up. Then from Coursera box, we have to get out of the Coursera box into greenhouses. NBAR, look to NBAR only as a supplier of organisms and the cultures. We have more than 108 live maintained parasitoids and predators, and any parasitoid or predators can be supplied. But we will never be able to give the farmers, okay? So, adoption of biocontrol is less than 3% in our country. And finally, I would like to tell, I've been running a journal called Insect Environment, where the subscription is free the last 24 years. And those of you who have short notes, interesting notes to write, please write. CABI is abstracting it. It is downloadable, absolutely free. And next year is the Silver Jubilee. Maybe I'll collaborate with BIPA and have a Silver Jubilee celebration for insect environment. Thank you very much, John. Thank you, Uda. And thank you all of you. Thank you. Thanks to all of you.
Thank you very much, sir.